Jada is back at it here to give everyone a health and wellness video, as I'm a stubborn guy. But to all of you out there, if there's a problem, if there's something wrong with your body, if you don't feel right, make sure that you make an appointment to see your physician or go see somebody as soon as possible, depending on the severity of it. Now, a little insight into this. So I had some sleep issues that started in sometime in 2018. I would sleep, but I have this daytime drowsiness that would affect me at work. Not bad to begin with, but it would affect me. Like, I'd be tired and kind of nod off here and there over a certain time period. Well, as the months went on, the situation got worse. Now, unrelated to this, I haven't seen a physician, or I hadn't at the time seen a physician since high school. I avoided them like you wouldn't believe, because I just got tired of going. And I made an appointment to have a physical. Nothing was wrong other than that. I just wanted to have one just in case there was something crazy wrong that they could potentially prevent in the future. So I scheduled a physical in late 2019 for first quarter of 2020. Of course, everybody had appointments already lined up because it was the new year. So my appointment was March 30th of 2020. And of course, because of COVID, that changed that. But what happened was, is my sleep was more of an issue as time went on. Got to be a big issue where it was like constantly through the day, if I'm not doing something very active, like I'm nodding off left and right. So I finally got a physical done on September of 2020. I don't remember the specific date. They kept getting canceled and rescheduled due to the coronavirus pandemic. And, you know, I told my doctor things that I thought were wrong. And I mentioned something about, you know, I'm dozing off all day long. Like, I don't know what's going on. Like, I'm not sleeping. And another story to that is, in late 2019, well, August of 2019, I got punched in the nose a little bit. And I think that messed up my breathing. So my sleep was even worse, where I couldn't really breathe out of my nose. And that's typically how I would breathe. So I had my physical in September of 2020. And I told my doctor about my sleep issues. And he's gonna refer me to a sleep specialist. So anyway, I ended up having the in-home sleep study, and the results, I mean, it didn't work very good, but the results, they did get something out of it, and it said my oxygen levels were under 50%. Normal good is 90%. Anything less than that isn't good, but when you're getting down under 50%, that's near death. So my body was having issues at night sleeping because I wasn't getting enough oxygen. I don't know what the cause of it all were, but to get into the sleep center, because that's the next step. If you have a really bad in-home study, then they want you to go to sleep center to test out different things on you. And so I ended up doing that December 1st of 2020, December 4th. Of 2020, had to have a COVID test to be able to go to the sleep center. I passed, obviously. And they put different CPAP styles on me, and I actually slept somewhat decent. You know, they kept waking me up to do stuff. But anyway, so I had to wait to get a CPAP machine. You know, it takes time to get that stuff. Well, then my sleeping got worse and worse to a point where I was peeing myself, very, not like there's a puddle underneath me, but I'd start tinkling, as I like to say, a little bit, and that would instantly wake me up. Something to do with, like, when you're sleeping, your body likes to shut down, and because I wasn't in a deep sleep, my body was never shutting down, so it'd be like, I'd just go to the bathroom every, you know, half an hour. So at night I was just tinkling here and there, and not like there was puddles or anything like that, but it's still like, what the fuck? So, any event, in late December of 2020, I finally got a CPAP machine, and I am happy to report that since that time, there's been no random accidents. And why I still wake up a couple times during my sleep is much better, and there has been no daytime drowsiness. So, back to the moral of the video, if you are experiencing some sort of issue, whether it be minor, whether it be major, you know, tell your physician about it. You know, make an appointment, go into the ER, something like that. You don't want this to affect you. Basically, they told me Not to alert anybody, but they told me I was gradually dying. Things were starting to shut down on my body because of my sleeping was not sleeping. So I'm glad I ended up doing that. It was annoying, to go into a place to sleep, but I got it done, and it's actually been quite life-changing. So I recommend to anybody that has any sort of problem, let your physician know. I'm the biggest culprit about it. Any problem with me, I deal with it. I'm stubborn, but now I'm a little bit more open if there's a problem to let somebody know, which I don't really have any problems other than that. Well, now my problem is I'd like to sleep all the way through the night, but I still wake up a couple times. It happens, but at least the sleep I'm getting is a lot better than the sleep I used to get. So that is the video. If you're a fan of this, if you're a fan of letting people know things are wrong with you and what to do to improve that, go ahead and smash that like button. If you know anybody that would be interested in this particular video of, talking, letting somebody know, share the video with them. If you have any questions or comments, anything you want to talk about, leave them in the comment section. I'm pretty open, so I don't mind sharing my issues. And of course, last but certainly not least, go ahead and hit that sub button, subscribe to the channel, join the team, show your damn support, and be a part of something special. And JDev will return.